third straight triple-double. I don't know. Have the Lakers have any good players since 1987? I just need to know.
I think a few.
Okay. Yeah. So he's he's only the second year there. Hmm. The third straight triple-double for the Washed King. Hmm. The Washed King. Hmm. Oh, he's so unathletic. His time is, he's no longer the best player. Mm. I heard a Hall of Famer and many other players say Kawhi Leonard does everything better than LeBron James except play basketball. Jenny, he out of PTO. 2 weeks into the season, he got no sick days left, but we're going to talk about him a little later.
Wow. Definitely later.
LeBron James keeps letting everyone know, Skip, what I knew to be true all along. He's still the best player in the NBA. Mm. Did you know over these last three games, he's averaging 30 points? 13 assists, 11 rebounds.
Wow.
I sure wish Kawhi could get me one of those. Mm. Skip, he kept them in the game when AD did not have it going. Skip, normally when you play professional sports and you go back and you have a player on your team and you're going back to his hometown, they do everything they can to try to get him going. You play the All-Star game, if one of the players on the team, you try to get him the MVP. Well, AD is in his hometown, Chicago. No, that's very special to him. And LeBron tried to get him going, and it didn't work out so well. AD was 1-for-6, -5 in the first quarter. And they were down, I think, 17 at the half, and LeBron James kept them in the game. He kept them afloat. Mm. And I know you're going to talk about the bench at some point in time, but the bench was the reason they got in this point. Mm. Because Kuzma in the first quarter, -5, Quinn Cook, -7, Caruso, -7, Troy Daniels, -4. Mm. So the deficit expanded when they came into the ball game. But LeBron James still controls the game. He still can score at an elite level, hence the 27.2 career average. He still can rebound at an elite level, even though he has AD, Dwight Howard, and JaVale McGee. He still got double-digit rebounds. Led the team again in points, rebounds, and assists, which is no shock. That's customary for him because he's still all-time great. And in the fourth quarter, LeBron James only scored 2 points. But he assisted 5, so for a total of 12. And see, the thing is that sometimes what great players struggle with, Jenny, is that they come in, they're like, okay, let me do this. I got to do my thing. Mm. He's like, nah, y'all got it going. Keep that thing going. Here you go, Kuz, take that. Mm. Quinn Cook, you got it going. Take that. And that's what LeBron separates LeBron from a lot of other great players, is that he understands the situation, and he doesn't always try to. And sometimes I get upset with him because I think he should interject. But in most cases, LeBron does not get caught up. Well, you see that guy scoring, you should try to go match him point for point. Hmm. LeBron says, nah, Kuzma got it going.
Yeah.
Let me try and help him find a rhythm because he had been struggling since he had come back. Let me try to help him find a rhythm. Kuzma made some shots, kept it going, 11 points in the fourth quarter, 15 overall. Quinn Cook got it going in the fourth quarter, played unbelievable. And they allowed those guys to finish out the ball game. Caruso finished out the ball game.
Sure.
Quinn Cook finished out the ball game. Mm. So this was unbelievable performance by LeBron James. I'm not surprised for an untalented, washed guy in year 17 to be doing this. Mm. All he's doing is averaging 26, 8, and 11. Mm. But he washed.
Wow.
Let you tell it.
Well, the only issue I would take with the question is the word back in it.
I would
posit he never left being the best player in basketball. Now, he was injured, and when you're injured, you don't have the ability to show it. But, yeah, LeBron, for the better part of 14 straight years now, has been the best player in the league, and someone's going to have to snatch that from him. And yesterday's win was an oddly really good win for the Lakers.
Yes.
Because they played so incredibly poorly for three quarters to a bad Bulls team that LeBron had 28, 9, and 6 through three quarters, and that just barely kept them in it. It took a fourth quarter run that I know you're going to get into that really put the Lakers in position to get a win that should have never been in question. The Bulls are a building young team with a question mark at head coach and question marks all over the roster, so it shouldn't have taken a great LeBron James game for them to win, but it did, and he, of course, provided it. And for those that want to argue, no, LeBron's not the best player in basketball, my only question would be, well, then who is? Mm-hmm. Kevin Durant is out for the season. He was on his way to taking what he feels is his rightful place, and it's not his fault, but unfortunately his Achilles snapped on him, and so we can't see him outside of that Golden State ecosystem for another full year. Kawhi is already load managing, and he's doing it again tonight. That'll be 25% of the season. Kawhi Leonard just said, nah, don't need to play. Just like last year, 25% of the season, he said, nah, don't need to play. The closest competition, to my eye, is Giannis. Mm-hmm. And Giannis was the one who last year looked like he was going to take it, winning league MVP. Team had the best record. But if you're going to be considered the best player in the NBA, you don't have to have won a championship, but you have to have gone on at least one epic playoff run. Giannis missed that opportunity last year, so it's going to be hard for him, even though he's the guy I think will eventually take the crown from LeBron. Mm-hmm. It's going to be hard for him to win over the public until he goes on like LeBron did in 07, a playoff run that was unlike anything we'd seen in recent history, even though it didn't win in a title. So, yeah, he's the best player in the league. And if you watch a game like last night, Canny, he's controlling every aspect of the game on both ends like the best player in the league is supposed to. Kawhi Leonard has a responsibility, not just to the Los Angeles Clippers, to the league, to its fans, and dare I say to its television partners. Kawhi Leonard is in year 9. He is 28 years old. We had a damn national emergency when LeBron James, in year 14, after 6 straight trips to the finals, took a couple games off due to load management. And for Kawhi to just be skipping nationally televised games, 2 of them, and we're 3 days past Halloween, is ridiculous. And you can say, as long as the Clippers win the title, nobody... Yeah, as long as they win the title. Can't now, though, all of a sudden, you're the 4 seed, when you could have been the 2 seed, and your second round matchup's harder than it needs to be, and you get bounced. We're going to go back to these days. Kawhi last year played 60. He was coming off an injury. Fine. He's not coming off an injury. He's now going to miss 2 of 8, and they're both on national TV. I hate it. I just hate it as a fan and as a consumer of the league.
No, Jen, you need to put emphasis on that.
Shannon, do you have a problem with it?
I got a big problem with that. Mm. It's the second time he's been out in 2 weeks of the NBA season. Mm. Don't make it seem like here we are 10 weeks into the NBA season. We're 2 weeks in, and he's already load managing. I just want to know how long you got to work to get PTO? I mean, how you start a new job?
Yeah.
You start a new job, and within the first 2 weeks, you're like, hey, I need some time off.
Mm. I hear you.
But your new employer really, really wanted you to join
him. I understand
that. That doesn't matter.
Skip, look. Look, obviously, this was a built-in condition. And this is what Clipper fans and NBA fans and television. Mm-hmm. Kawhi's not playing back-to-backs. So if you got him on your network and you think you're not getting him back-to-backs, as long as he's where he is right now, mm-hmm. he's not playing back-to-back, Skip. I'm sorry. And you would have thought. Can you imagine? Now, I just want to know one thing, Skip Baylor. Let's just say for the sake of argument, I'm not surprised for an untalented, washed guy in year 17 to be doing this. Mm. All he's doing is averaging 26, 8, and 11, but he's washed.
Wow.
Let you tell it. Boy, bye. I heard a Hall of Famer and many other players say Kawhi Leonard does everything better than LeBron James except play basketball. Jenny, he out of PTO. 2 weeks into the season, he got no sick days left, but we're going to talk about him a little later.
Kawhi Leonard's got the throne. LeBron has done nothing to knock him off. They went head-to-head. LeBron didn't want it. Kawhi got it. His team won, and that's in spite of the fact that LeBron James had AD and Kawhi didn't have Paul George. Look, LeBron's around 30. Kawhi's around 35. Now, that's mainly an offensive statistic. So offensively, Kawhi is a more efficient player. Defensively, Kawhi's a better player than LeBron.
Let me tell you where you throw that PER right out the window with that quote, that blasphemous quote that you just gave. Kawhi Leonard definitely might be more efficient offensively as a scorer at this particular juncture because he's insane from the free throw line compared to LeBron, who obviously struggles from the free throw line. But excuse me, in terms of passing the ball, getting other people involved, last time I checked, that's offensive efficiency. And we all know that LeBron is a more efficient player from that scope.
And LeBron might be the best passer in basketball, one of the greatest passers of all time. And that's the one weakness in Kawhi's game until this season. Kawhi is becoming an excellent passer, and that's the only thing that was missing in his game.
Zip it. You said becoming.
Yes.
That means he's en route. I'm sorry, LeBron's already there and has been there for years. And how do we know this? Because Max Kellerman has been on national television for years. Oh, Stephen A., LeBron James, balling. Getting other people involved. This dude is the best, maybe the best passer ever. That's you. So don't sit up here now and change it up and talk about Kawhi Leonard is coming in.
You know what, LeBron Max? Does better
route.
Than him.
Are you ready for this, Max? I'm en route to running 5 miles a day. Guess what? I ain't there yet, bro.
You're 2.5.
I ain't there yet. I'm going that
You're
way.
You're 2.5.
I got ways to go.
What are we, half mile right now?